that is going another way. The lights are down there. Let's have a look over here.
Doing? I saw you doing that.
Stay away from me. Don't come near me.
This is people's property. You're scaring them.
It's all over the village. It's got into everything. It's so fast.
What are you talking about?
It's traveling down the wires.
Dear God, when you lost your mind? Where is Kate? What have you done with her?
Don't you understand? It's breaching the quarantine and adapting.
Give me that bloody can. Hand it over, Appleton.
No, get off.
No, Sam, stop it. You weedy little shit.
It's mine.
Give me the can.
Give me the can.
Grow up! Fucking hell.
Starting to manifest itself everywhere.
Stephen, come back!
Oh, Christ!
Well. Oh! I think he was talking about this. That's not a normal paint spill. So, yeah. I think they found something at the observatory and it's gone out somehow. Some kind of signal that's out and about and is possibly causing all the bleeding and stuff. Not entirely sure why he had the paint can though. But yeah. So there's Sam there as well. There's another person. Another woman. I think the light is anxious for us to go down that way, so let's go down that way and have a look.
Where's Kate?
Where do you think she is?
Stephen, what's going on?
Screw Kate. It's all her fault anyway.
What's that mark on your face? Stephen! Stephen!
Well. The light went off that way. Village green, I guess. That's pretty neat. Can't go all the way in, but we can make a ripple. Here. with little patches around. And get through the back. Yeah, a lot of this is just kind of exploring everything and sticking your nose everywhere and seeing what things there are to see. Something's happened there. Hello? Don't think anyone's around. Whee! That's really cool. I used to love doing that as a kid. Nice. And we can't get back around. Okay. Well, there's a church up there. Probably where Jeremy does his thing. Robert Graves. Probably another character that we shall meet. Let's investigate the green.
Benjamin, Georgie, leave it alone. It might have fleas.
Hello, Amanda. What are they up to?
Oh, they found another dead bird. I do wish the council would clean them up.
Well, apparently they're saying it's a flu epidemic. And I gather they'll be closing the roads and stations, so they're worried enough for that.
Oh, for goodness sake.
Well, you don't mess about with the flu outbreak, I suppose. But look, I'm just saying, if you were planning on taking the kids to Wales, now might be the time to do it.
Well, thanks, Barbara. I'll have word with Neil, see what he thinks. Now, George, Benjamin, for God's sake, leave it alone!
Oh. There's blood around the head too. They're getting nosebleeds and all. Huh. Oh, that's neat. Stuck. Oh no. Help me. Oh dear. I may have got myself stuck. Oh, there's a little plastic sword. Oh, there we go. Phew. Thought I might be in trouble there. Oh, hello. Big ball of light, hello. Where do you want me to go? Up the hill. Peter Pan, Lakeside Holiday Night, or Holiday Camp, sorry. Huh. Autumn. There's a lot of butterflies on the map. I'm pretty sure this is out of the ordinary. VX gas. Well, that's disturbing. Stephen was talking about a strike earlier on, talking to Clive. And they dropped bombs on the place? To try and stop this? Jesus. I'm pretty serious about that then. Bombs in the village green. Just got the front door. There are flies buzzing. I don't like that. Oh, they're butterflies. Interesting. Can't get in this one. There's another radio somewhere.
Magnetic field is causing disruptions to phone signals and the rest of the electrics. There are voices on the line. It's 4 a.m. Maybe everyone is up looking at the light show.
It's like Day of the Triffids. Chaos theory. That must have been pretty new around then. So what on earth is back here? A bit weird. Definitely a butterfly theme here, isn't there? Over there. back over there. Huh. Well, this is somebody's rather nice house. Can't go in, apparently. Oh, bees. And a phone. Somebody is keeping bees. Know where that phone is, though.
You have to make a decision, Lizzie. Especially now.
But I do love him, Father. I love them both.
He's married. There are other people involved in this.
Oh, I hardly think that anyone's in the position to claim the moral high ground, do you?
Well, I take your point about Stephen. And Robert. But I think Kate might see things differently.
Do you? I mean, she's not screwing anyone else, pardon my French, but she spends all day and night locked up in that observatory. Stephen says they barely see each other. That's hardly a marriage, is it?
With a village gossip, eh? And Lizzie, who is also an important character in all this. Off up there. I'm a little afraid to. Apparently, people have a lot of paint. Lots and lots of paint. Nothing, apparently. So yeah, we're kind of doubling back on ourselves here a bit, which I'm not entirely keen on. Find that phone. Well, I mean, imagine that. You're a doctor, you know you're dying. Like, and you don't know what the hell is happening. That is just terrifying. Also, the music there was very, very good. So yeah, whatever this is, sure isn't the flu. And this presumably is a surgery. Yeah, no. Cover story, clearly. Something's going on that nobody understands. Lots of people coming in here with bleeding, aren't they? Birds and butterflies. Oh God. This is not good.
Dr. Wade, here you are. There's a queue of patients a mile long out there.
Just send them to the village hall with the others, please, Bob.
Doctor, people are scared. Mrs. Gables just called me and said her husband's vanished. She was very frightened. She said there was blood coming out from his ears and his
what
nose.
What the hell do you want me to do? Until they lift the quarantine, we're not going anywhere. Just tell them to drink plenty of fluids, stay warm, and follow the instructions on the radio.
Doctor, Phil, please, you have a duty to your patient. Your nose.
Well, yeah, they're all succumbing to it. God, blood everywhere, Jesus. Video things, you could see Tower 6 on there. Maybe that's the epicenter of all this. Bloody hell. This must have been absolutely terrifying. I mean, people, you know, I mean, you're in a village in the middle of the countryside. You don't know what the hell's going on. When something like this happens, for sure, you've got absolutely no experience of anything remotely like this. They must have all been absolutely terrified, as we have seen. So, this is Brambles. I don't know where we are now. There's the green. Little ball of light. Well, maybe you going up here is the next step. Yikes. I don't know if that's good or bad. Those petrol prices. No? Anyone in the garage? Oh, hello.
Meg, come and have a look at this.
Oh, I don't believe it. Charlie?
Jeremy reckons someone had been raiding all the empty houses. He said a load of stuff had been taken.
What's that?
It looks like someone's been collecting their own supplies.
Bastard.
Well, we've got enough stock in the warehouse to keep the entire village going for months.
We should get a truck.
What, and go and get all of it now?
Yeah, why not?
It's Appleton. It's that bloody crackpot, Stephen Appleton. I'm gonna fucking do him.
Sam, it's fine. We better get moving before the weather turns. You come in. We'll swing by the camp and get Rachel on the way back.
Ah, there's a light. So, Charlie, Sam, and, damn it. Forgotten what the woman's name was. Meg?
Meg, possibly.
Alright, looks like we want to go in here. He's off down there, eh? Well, very nice. And what is going on here though? There's some distortions and strange things happening. Are you going in? Hello? So we go in that way. More blood.
I saw you from the main road. Not many people are moving around now.
I was looking for Dr. Wade.
Listen, Frank. I don't know what's happened, but your Stephen seems to think he's responsible.
I reckon he is.
He said, Kate's still up at the observatory, but the gates are locked. Frank, there's gonna be a rescue soon, I'm sure of it. They'll send planes or something.
Well, they'll send planes, all right. This pattern of his, we're in the center of it. Which means if they intend to stop it, we're right in the firing line.
Those bells weren't sounding before. So Frank is another one. Frank is evidently Stephen's dad. Oh God, oh my God, look at this. Jesus. So they bleed and then they kind of just vanish, like into motes, like what we saw with, I think it was Amanda's kids. But some people are unaffected. Like, Frank seemed okay there, and Jeremy's been wandering around. Wonder what's up with that. Where's this radio? Thank you.
was just some distortion of physics. I may not understand it yet, but it wasn't an accident. All of the clocks, what happened at Tower 6, that's just not random. There's an effort. An attempt to communicate.
Oh. They picked up some kind of, I don't know, energy life form thing, maybe. Hello. Church clock says 6:07 again.
Well, I really don't see what it has to do with me at all.
The village looks up to you. I just think with what's been happening with Mr. Coles and Mrs. Boughton and the others, that people need somewhere to talk, to feel safe.
Perhaps they don't think that your church is somewhere they feel particularly safe.
I don't need your forgiveness, Wendy. Or theirs. Whosoever thou art that judgest, for wherein thou judgest another, thou condemnest thyself. Romans chapter 2, verse 1.
Beware of practicing your righteousness before other people in order to be seen by them. Matthew chapter 6, verse 1. It's not my judgment you should be worried about, Father. But fine. I'll talk to Barbara. Ask her to put a note up in the surgery about an extra service. Will that do?
Wow. So, Wendy. She is an interesting one. She's like, the village matriarch, shall we say, I guess, by the sound of it. Let me just have a look around here. Bells. They are very persistent. I'm guessing this is Wendy's house. Clearly knows her Bible enough to put the vicar in his place. Although there was some kind of funny tension there, wasn't there? He'd done something maybe that she at least was unhappy about. Hello?
Are you there?
Oh, mate.
Can you hear me? Are you out there, you bastard? You got them all? them all.
Blimey.
Jesus Christ. Help me, O Lord. Give me strength. Hello? Hello, is anyone there? Is anyone still there? Oh, oh. You are still here then. I should have expected that. Come on then. Let's get this over and done with. I've got my parishioners to attend to.
Jeremy was the last one left here. All these little flames kind of captured. Let's see what transpires now.
Their line has gone out through all the earth, and their words to the end of the world. In them hath he set a tabernacle for the sun. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Jeremy. Well, poor guy was scared out of his wits. Oh well, look at that. And then just got, I don't know, taken? Dissolved? Without nosebleeds, apparently. This is just beautiful and sad.